So let me talk to these NPCs first. I think that's everyone. So let's start the party. Because I'm gonna run in a samurai and hopefully Yashtola busts out some AoE damage. Oh, maybe I should have went with Yorianje. He gives DPS cards. Oh well. Liking the music. I'm not gonna do multi-group pulls because I don't trust these NPCs, but if you were in a group with real people, I'm betting you could just keep on running and pull like more than one group here. Like the Trust NPCs barely do any AoE, so it really sucks. Also right now I have no idea how to play Samurai. I completely forget. Not sure what the AoE rotation even is. I'm just making it up as I go. Not like this is too difficult in terms of difficulty. Also, I'm trying to like look at the NPCs to see if they say anything. So like distracting me. He just says, "Darkness must be purged." Yeah, he's giving flavor texts. Trying to keep an eye out for those.
Prepare yourself.
Yeah, that definitely could have been a double pull. There's only two guys here. I'm not sure if using the AoE moves on two NPCs, two enemies, is worth it on Samurai. I don't actually know where the cutoff is for these AoE abilities. Definitely should look it up someday, but it's not like I'm in any huge rush. Oh, so it's pretty cool. They made a little path for us. Gets helpers. Mighty Talos.
Hey,
But I definitely need to up the damage on these trusts. It's just a bit too slow. Flavor text? Okay. Oh wait, that's not our AoE. I thought that was our AoE. Oh wait, what killed our Talos? Did he just randomly die? My god, they have so much health! Freaking the stroller needs to more. Oh, I guess they don't last that long. That one deactivated also. And I guess it's first boss time. Let's see what these guys say. Aether is bright, and it's a thief or a ninja. I'm trying to read his flavor text, I'm messing up. What's going on here? Am I supposed to push that? Oh shit, that's where he jumps! I was debated. I thought I had to like interact with it or something. Oh, okay, I see. I understand now. Hey, why is everyone gathering in the middle there? What's gonna happen? Oh, shit. I guess he's gonna jump there, so I should avoid that spot. I guess I could have did more hits on him. He had the whole countdown circles around him, so he could stay in his AoE for a bit. Plus he jumps anyway, so I guess he could stay in the middle. It's perfectly safe. Oh, I guess that side of the map is not safe. And it's dead. Hey, it's fuel. Oh. Oh, indeed. Summon the portal for us? Oh, hey, we're in Illmeg now. I guess when it goes through all the zones. And oh, the pixies are helping us this time too. Christ, these things are so tanky. Although I bet they probably map maps pretty fast, those regular players. It just feels so slow when you're with Trust. That guy turned into a Leafman. Oh, this dude's back. The Lengthsome Gate. Oh, that's cool. He's doing all the bullshit that he did to us in that one dungeon. Absolute protect doesn't sound good. Let me stun that. So much health. Pretty cool. Guess we are still fighting. He goes off to fight over there. Interesting. Oh, and here's the Numo. The Numo and Amaro are here. Are they gonna follow me? Oh, these guys are ink mages, they're not black mages. That's interesting. Oh, and it's the trees from Titania. Should be three trees, we're missing one tree. Okay, I guess, oh, it's the next boss. Let's see what it says. Huh. Oh, it's a necromancer. Is that hint to a new job? Although, it doesn't really sound very hero-y. Aren't like necromancers usually evil? I mean, I guess there are good necromancers in some stories. What the hell is going on here? Seems like all the pieces are gathered in the middle. Doesn't look good, I guess. Yeah, okay, everyone's running away. I was like, everyone's just standing there, maybe it's okay. Nope. It's those puddles from, that Ozma dungeon. I wonder if we're gonna have to Mega Death. Okay, what's going on here? These are different than the previous ones. Oh, they grabbed me. I guess I can still attack. I probably should just be beside a boss. Oh, and then it explodes. Okay, so that one you just wanna spread them out, I guess. So I think the first set, you wanna gather them together and then move away. And the second set, you want to just spread out. Okay, so now both of these are together, so I guess we just want to spread out and avoid the ones that just fell. Avoid the non-grabby ones. Almost dead. Have you seen all the mechanics? That I should lose again. Oh. That's pretty cool. Alright, pretty cool, pretty cool. I guess we're at Lake Land now, we're almost at the Crystarium. Here is, all those job quest guys, or I guess, role quest. I like the Geot. He's very funny. Although I thought she, took off her helmet, or something. Yeah, the helmet was used to kill the Sin Eater. What if? Why did she have the helmet back? I don't know. And wasn't there supposed to be two other guys? Where's the... Who else was there? There's a tank at least. Maybe they show up later here. Oh, there's the tank. They're having a full-blown conversation. Lots of flavor text, very cool. Gonna come with me? No, I guess that's done with them. Oh, no, they're still following along. Oh, they're talking more. Get on to the next group. Oh, cool. It's casting the wings thing, the paladin thing. Arrows don't do a thing. Oh, shit. He's doing a limit break. He got wrecked. That is cool. I like that. That was pretty epic. Alright, I guess this is where they end, and we proceed on. Oh, looks like this is the last lost area. Got my mapping achievement. Berserker. It's very cool. Although I don't know if that's like a new job, because I mean 14 already kind of has a berserker with warrior, but this is like half Dark Knight, half warrior. Something? Oh, okay, I guess it's just a line AoE. Standing around it, so I guess I'll stand around it too. guess it's a like a Sephiroth knockback. Oh shit, what the hell is that? Okay, I get it. You can't go into the pit. Oh wait, what the hell? What the hell, what do I do? Okay, I guess I see the rubble. Back. Everyone's going here, so I'm just gonna go in here with them. Oh, I see. You dodge his cleave by being lower in the ground. It also gives you a debuff, a bit berserk. It says that if you stay too long, I guess you'll get a berserk debuff. Looks like he's gonna do some more craters in the ground. Is he just gonna fill the field with those? Oh shit, I forgot, I gotta get in here. Oh, and it's that rubble thing again. Nothing too difficult. Seems like he's almost dead. Almost have my little break too. Here it is. They can take the stack. They got enough people. And there it goes. Gang's all here. Let's see what they have to say. This crater's pretty cool. I guess could be a cool screenshot area. Oh, can I go down here? Is there something over here? Oh no, there's a invisible wall. Okay, let's continue with the quest.
I think that's the last of them.
Apparently even they have limits. Nevertheless, we should remain vigilant.
Uriangier, something occurred to me while we were fighting. These enemies...
Are heroes hailing from other shards, summoned hither to deliver this world from its doom. Scant moments after the star shower did they appear, as yet more souls were inspired to walk the hero's path, no doubt. Thus did hopes for salvation of realms near and far resonate and converge, lending still greater strength unto our adversary.
So that's Elidibus's game. But first things first. If the rings are the same as the Exarch's, then we need to ask him how that's possible.
The Crystarium is close. Let us press on.
They come.
So near and yet so far.
In the chaos of conflict, one can always find an opening to exploit.
Whoever taught you that is a wise man indeed, and good with a gun, mate. But yes, I dare say we can create an opening wide enough for at least one of us to slip through. That being you, of course. No others are welcome to follow in your way. Green and I will keep our guests occupied.
Brave and selfless as ever. Yet the two of you may struggle to fool our foes, etherically sensitive as they are. Had you a comrade who could use destructive magics to wreak havoc upon the ambient ether, on the other hand?
Very well. I too shall assist in the diversionary effort.
Oh, not this old dance again.
Yes, obviously, I'll stay and fight. Alphano, I'm about to do a great many stupid and reckless things. Watch my back, would you?
There you have it. Take care of yourself, my friend.
Make a nice big opening. I got the girth.
We'll do our best.
Finished? Then let's begin.
She just straight up cast the break three. A short while earlier, so I guess it's about to explain what happened to the Crystal Exarch here and why his power is being used to summon all those things.
Tis done.
Oh, let me see, let me see! Memories are preserved safely within. We've done it. We've done it at last.
I have inspected the other vessels. They are all ready to receive of our friends' memories.
Oh, excellent. Excellent. I shall have my familiars bear word to them at once.
Oh, shit.
Elidibus.
It was not until I observed the battle between Emmet Selk and the Warrior of Darkness that I realized what I must do. I will summon heroes from other worlds unto the first, just as you did. Their presence shall serve to empower me, granting me the strength to crush my enemy.
Though it pains me to disappoint you, I feel compelled to explain that the magic in question requires no small amount of preparation.
Ah, but you assume I require my champions to be summoned in their entirety. I do not. Their souls needn't even be whole. My purpose requires no more than their burning desire to vanquish evil. This I shall sear upon the ether, raising thereby an army of phantom heroes to whom I shall whisper, as I have to so many over the ages. Here lies darkness. It must be destroyed.
And you expect me to cooperate?
I do not require your cooperation. Your death will suffice. The magic I shall have from your corpse. Go, Lubus! We must flee! What is this?
My friend, how did you... No matter, Elidibus, he took us unawares.
It was all we could do, to raise a ward to hinder his steps. And so we fled, but he took it. With a vessel with the Exarch's memories. Forgive me, forgive me.
The vessel bears not only my memories, but my blood. The blood of Allegan royalty, granting him the means to control the tower. With it, he has performed I know not how many summonings, calling forth heroes from across the rift. And, as you can see, the burden upon the tower is beginning to tell. No, I won't let you go alone. Not this time. Elidibus has exploited the people's nobility, twisted their purest intentions for terrible ends, and I cannot let it stand. As Exarch, it is my duty to protect them, to defend their hopes and dreams. So I am going to the Crystal Tower, with or without your blessing. Though, I would rather it were with. Thank you.
I joined you, but I would only be a burden. Better that I remain here with my gremlin.
I shall send help. Stay strong, my friend, and take heart. By binding Elidibus within the tower, we have done more than simply delay him. Much like our adversary, I am not wont to show my hand prematurely, but the time has come to bring my strongest card to bear. to the tower.
Pretty cool. I guess they tracked him in the tower. Kind of makes sense. Alagons are pretty good at primals and Asians and fighting them. Okay, I guess I'm gonna cut the video here. Thanks for watching. I guess that's a new dungeon for this patch. It's pretty fun. I liked it.